this is my second video and my first official tutorial video. So today I'm gonna be quick and easy, show you how to do the variety of different things that you can do with the eyes, which are some of my favorite things to do because eye edits are so easy, but they're like unlimited. You can do anything with them and it's really cool. So I'm gonna show you different things that you can do with overlays, changing the shape and colors and tints, and there's so many things you can do. So we're gonna explore it all today. Again, I'll be using my Nikon D3100 DSLR camera and picmonkey.com to edit, which is free and really fun. So let's get started. Okay, now's the time I'm gonna answer the question of the day. So I picked a question from Chloe_can_do_it. And she asked me, when did I start editing? Okay. I'm a junior in high school now. I'm almost 17. I discovered the fact that pictures didn't have to just stay how they were when I was probably like 13. And as a little middle schooler, I used to just edit things and add text to things. And I put a filter on everything. Like, it was bad. I go back to all my pictures, I filtered everything, and I was obnoxious. But I started actually editing pictures and photo manipulation probably into my freshman year, and then started my account as a sophomore when I got my actual camera. I picked up this account again at the beginning of this year. So to answer your question, I've been editing probably for 3 or 4 years? I'd safely say 3 years. But yeah. Okay. Send in your questions, guys, and I will gladly answer them. And also, drop your usernames below if you want me to check you out. That would be, you know, a great opportunity to get noticed, you know. Follow at Rad Rapunzel if you want to. Alright, so I've got here, let me turn this down. Okay, so I have my stock of eye photos that I took with, again, my Nikon D3100 camera right here, and for this video, let's choose, let's go with this one right now. This is iEdit4. I'm going to open up picmonkey.com right here, select edit, scroll down and find it, iEdit4. And there it is. Alright, so the first few edits I'm going to show you are simple overlay edits. So we select overlay here on the side, which in my first video I went over what each of these are right here. Go to Google and we'll do a simple galaxy edit. So I look up tons of galaxy backgrounds here. And ooh, this is pretty. This is literally how I do everything. Save it. Galaxy 1. Alright, now everything you do, whether it is putting a galaxy over your eye or a different, like I have a clock one, I'll probably show examples. Whatever you're putting on your eye, you're going to upload it as a overlay, place it on here like this, and it is really simple. You can even decide how you want to blend it. So for the sake of this, this is normal, add, darken, difference, hard light, lighten, overlay, multiply, screen. I think I'm gonna go with hard light. I like how that looks. And then really simple, erase away where you don't want it. It's really easy. It's like coloring almost. So hang on. Let's find where this eyeball is. And then paint it on in there. Okay, and, whoop, I missed a spot. Okay, and voila, that's how you basically put anything on your eye. And here's the different things you can do with it here. Again, I'm going to stay with hard light. You can fade it, decide how much you want on. Let's go with like right here-ish. And you can change the color of what you're putting on as well. Okay, so I'm going to stay with that. And I'll save it really quick just for the heck of it. I edit 4-1. Okay. So let's see what else we can do. Whether you want to put... whether maybe you want to put water. Over your eye, give it a nice watery texture here. And let's see. And there's that, really simple and easy. There's water. Okay, so basically with this overlay method, you can put anything onto your eye or onto any picture, basically, and that's really just what I'm trying to get at. You can also use PNGs, like here's the moon, I don't know. Any of y'all saw Fetching Tiger's most recent edit? Yeah, that's really easy and simple to do, and I can do a tutorial on that if you'd like to, but this is it in essence. Let's go with that right there. And then erase around. Really easy to do. Okay, I'm gonna save that real quick for 3. And here, let's look what we got here. I edit 5. And we'll open up a new picture. And I'll show you something that's a little bit harder to do. But it's another thing you can do. Let's see. So I went ahead and pulled up this same photo in another website called ribbit.com, which is equally amazing when it works. So, as in, it's kind of a funny button, but I select Goofify. Okay. And that, let's start it really low. Let's see. Photos in the way that I want them to go. So I don't know if any of y'all have seen that little teardrop drooping effect type thing, but that's essentially what this does right now. You can just use this to distort images to whatever the heck you want. Just a little tool that I'd show you. I mean, this length and flashes, kind of. Here, I've already destroyed this eye there. Yeah. That's that. Okay, and then the last thing, big thing you can do is, where'd you go? I use this tint button to change the colors of things that I want. So say that you really do not like having brown eyes. Personally, I think they're beautiful. I don't have them myself, but I would really like to. So say you don't. Say your eyes are brown and you don't like it. You can always, whoop, that's too big. Add in a splash of whatever color that you want them to be. And here. And this again is your spectrum on how it would blend. Hard light, light, and multiply are often good ones. I like hard light. There's really bluish, greens, ooh, red, scary. I kind of like how that red looks. It's rubyish and freaky. You know, or like black. Well, it's not that dark, but black. Reds, whole rainbow, and you can do this one by one on little sections to get that rainbow effect you want, or just overlay a rainbow right into there. That almost looks like my real eye color, but I'm gonna leave it as this red here. So yeah, that's that. Or you can do the same thing here, and I have a picture like this that kind of shows this example, and tint the eye around. Hang on, do this real quick. Get original for the eye color. There and do, well, that's kind of spooky. Let's see, what did I do the first time? Overlay is pretty good. Now add that in there. There we go, and fade that as much as you want to make it look more realistic, but we can go with that for right now. That's scary looking. Go to Google here. This is just how to recreate my one photo I have. And it might not work because it took me forever to actually find the water droplet. So hang on. Yeah. You know what? I think I actually just have it. So we'll save that red color. And overlays. Throw in that here. Water. Drop. Right there. Yeah, and add in that little drop of water right here. Really, really simple and easy. And anyone can do it. And there's, in a sense, really quickly how to recreate that. And then again, you just save and you're done. Okay, so I hope that this helped you learn three really quick, easy ways to edit eye photos, like so, and that you'll subscribe and watch the next videos. Definitely suggest what you would like to see, different things, tutorials, anything you would like to see done, and I'll get to doing them. I really hope this helped you out. Follow me at Rad Rapunzel, and drop your usernames below, and I'll check you out. All right. Stay tuned. Adios, guys.